knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Before we discuss the strange encrusting moss animals of phylum Bryozoa, let's return to our cladogram of all animal phyla. Notice that the last four spiralian phyla we have yet to discuss, Bryozoa, Entoprocta, Brachiopoda, and Phoronida, are grouped close together, and they kind of look similar. They're actually all part of the clade Lophophorata. We will summarize their differences a bit later. For now, we're going to focus solely on the Bryozoans, the largest of the four phyla. Phylum Bryozoa, also known as phylum Ectoprocta, meaning outside anus, are tiny aquatic animals, usually about half a millimeter long, that often encrust hard surfaces. They are characterized by a specialized feeding structure called a lophophore, which is a crown-like structure of tentacles used for filter feeding. In order to study these, let's discuss their taxonomy, colony structure, feeding, reproduction, and fossil forms. Bryozoans are generally split into three classes: the freshwater obligate members of Phylactolemata, the exclusively marine members of Stenolemata, and the sessile, mainly marine members of Gymnolemata. There are about 5,900 currently confirmed species, only four of which are solitary, and all the rest are colonial. Bryozoan colonies can take a variety of forms, from fans to bushes to sheets to ropes to branching coral-like structures. Many freshwater colonies resemble amorphous blobs that are often mistaken for egg masses or clumps of algae. The tiny colony members are called zooids, which are comprised of a polypid and cystid. The polypid is comprised of a lophophore, digestive tract, muscles, and nerves. They feed by extending their lophophores into the surrounding water to collect tiny suspended particles. Note that their mouth is located within the lophophore crown, while their anus is located outside of it, hence the name Ectoprocta, or outside anus. The cystid includes the body wall and zoecium. The zoecium is an exoskeleton-like structure or chamber that is secreted by individual zooids. Some species secrete zoecium that are gelatinous, others are chitinous, while still others are tough and stiffened with calcium. Some colonies can form encrustations on seaweed, shells, and rocks, while others form large branching growths that stand erect and resemble seaweed. Most individual polypids are able to rapidly retract completely into their chambers when disturbed, using their retractor muscle. Many species also have a tiny trap door called an operculum that can be shut to completely protect the tiny bryozoan. In order to reemerge, the polypid uses a combination of muscular movements that increase hydrostatic pressure and pushes the lophophore out using hydraulics. While extended, the bryozoan extends its lophophore and spreads its tentacles to create a feeding funnel. Cilia located on the tentacles draw water into the funnel and out between the tentacles. Suspended organic matter that is captured by the ciliated tentacles are drawn down into the mouth, essentially by a ciliated conveyor belt. Inedible particles are rejected by reversing the ciliary action, essentially reversing the ciliated conveyor belt. Digestion begins in the ciliated U-shaped digestive tract. Bryozoans have a complete digestive tract with a mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, gizzard, cecum, intestine, and anus. They also have a nervous system that is comprised of a ganglionic mass and a nerve ring that surrounds the pharynx, though they lack a respiratory, circulatory, and urinary system. Most of their gas exchange is done through simple diffusion along the body surface, and the fluid-filled coelom transports most of the nutrients from the digestive tract to surrounding cells. In addition, pores in the walls between connected zooids allow exchange of fluids throughout the colony. As such, these individual zooids are not completely independent. Though most colonies contain only feeding individuals, there are some species that contain zooids incapable of feeding. The most common non-feeding zooids are avicularia, which are protective or defensive zooids that lack lophophores and resemble beaks, capable of snapping at invading organisms. Vibracula, which have modified opercula that resemble a long defensive bristle. Structural polymorphs, which consist of only the body wall and help to form the stems of branching structures, and reproductive polymorphs, most of which are gonozooids that serve as brood chambers for fertilized eggs, though male polymorphs that produce sperm are known to exist as well. Most bryozoans are hermaphroditic and spawn in unison. Some simply release eggs into the seawater, though most use gonozooids to brood eggs until they are ready to hatch into free-swimming larvae that settle and undergo a radical metamorphosis, forming a new colony. The single bryozoan progenitor of a new colony is known as an ancestrula. A successful ancestrula will undergo asexual budding to produce the numerous zooids of a colony. In addition to sexual reproduction, freshwater bryozoans undergo a unique form of asexual reproduction that involves the production of statoblasts, which are tough, resistant capsules that contain a mass of reproductive cells. In temperate regions, they form in the late summer and fall. When the adult colony dies in late fall or early winter, the statoblast remains until conditions are favorable in the early spring, when they give rise to new colonies. Though Bryozoa is now a smaller phylum, they are the most diverse of Lophophorata, and their fossil record is rich. They are some of the most dominant groups of Paleozoic fossils, and over 15,000 species have been found thus far. Their fossils are incredibly common in marine sediments worldwide, from the Ordovician onward, though they are often small and fragmented. Their evolutionary tree is still debated, and their placement within kingdom Animalia is potentially subject to change. One last thing to mention is that the term Bryozoa is sometimes abandoned in favor of Ectoprocta, because phylum Bryozoa originally contained both the Ectoproctans and the Entoproctans, though the two have been recognized as separate phyla since at least 1870. And that is actually the topic of the next tutorial, so for now, let's say goodbye to Bryozoa and move forward to explore phylum Entoprocta.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.